गुड मॉर्निंग डियर चिल्ड्रेन एंड वेलकम बैक फॉर योर इंग्लिश ऑनलाइन क्लासेस। एज इन द प्रीवियस क्लास वी हैव स्टार्टेड अ न्यू चैप्टर फ्रॉम इंग्लिश ग्रामर नाउंस व्हिच इज़ अ नेम ऑफ अ प्लेस पर्सन और थिंग। देन वी लर्नड अबाउट द काइंड्स ऑफ नाउन। हाउ मेनी काइंड्स ऑफ नाउन्स आर देयर? कॉमन, प्रॉपर, कलेक्टिव, एब्स्ट्रैक्ट एंड मटेरियल। Then we learnt about common nouns, that it is common names for any person, place, thing or idea, and it is not at all starting with the capitalization. Only if it is the beginning of the sentence, then we have to start it with capital. Then we learnt about proper nouns, that for special name to a particular person, place or thing, we are giving proper noun, and it always starts with a capital letter. Then we learnt about collective nouns, that is the group of people, group of animals and group of things, that is the collection of people, animals and things are known as collective noun. Then we learnt about abstract noun, that an abstract noun is a word which names something that you cannot see, hear, touch, smell or taste, but you can feel, like truth, faith, idea, success, evil, all these. Then material noun, I told you, all the raw materials. Before the finished product, all the raw materials which we are taking to prepare a finished product, that comes under your material noun. That can be wheat, gold, coal, glass. Then we learned from the book the definition of nouns, its type. First one I gave as homework. Then we have discussed the second one. Using common nouns, then match the following abstract nouns. Now we will start countable and uncountable nouns. Before reading this, I'll show you something for countable and uncountable nouns. This one only. Did you know some nouns like advice, hair, luggage, information, poetry, furniture, scenery, etc. have only the singular form? So this is the important thing that you have to keep in your mind, because many questions related to countable and uncountable nouns, these kinds of words will be there in the questions. And according to this, if this will be in your mind, then you won't be able to do any kind of mistakes. Okay, like furniture, if we'll say, we will think that all chair, then sofa, bed, all comes under furniture, but it is given over here, have only the singular form. Okay, furnitures we are not writing, it is furniture only. Poetries we are not writing, it is poetry only. So before to that, let's start countable and uncountable nouns. Countable nouns are things you can count. This we have learned earlier also. And uncountable nouns are things you cannot count. Countable nouns can be singular or plural. It can be singular, it can be plural. Like for example, pen. A pen, if I say, it will be only one pen. But if I say 10 pens, that means pens, plural, but 10 I said. Can we count 10? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Yes, we can count 10. That's why it will be a countable noun, as well as singular or plural can also be a countable noun. When the noun stands for only one thing or person, it is said to be in the singular number. But when the noun stands for only one thing or person, it is said to be a singular number. When the noun stands for more than one person or thing, it is said to be a plural form. That is obvious, no? That if we are saying one person's name, or if we are taking one thing, then it will be singular. And if we are taking more than one person's name, then, or more than one thing if we are taking, it will come under your plural form. Uncountable nouns have only one form. But uncountable nouns have only one form. Okay? No singular, plural, it is only one form. See the first one given, underline the correct answers. Where have you left your luggage? Luggages. What will come over here? Just now I told you about this example. See, luggage. That means we never write luggages. Whether it is singular or plural, every time we will be writing only luggage. The house it is made of brick or bricks. Brick means only one brick. Eat, eata. Okay, but bricks means many. So bricks will be the answer. The scenery or sceneries look beautiful. For scenery also we have seen over here. So scenery will come. The doctor gave me some advice. Advice or advices? Advice. We never say advices. Meena has short hair or hairs. This I am teaching you from last how many years, I too don't know. But we never say hairs. Every time we say hair. In the same way, now you people will solve 6 to 15 by yourselves. And kindly keep this, did you know, also in your mind. Words like spectacles, trousers, scissors, tongs, binoculars, alms, shots, savings, old skirt, outskirts, valuables, particulars, surroundings, etc. are considered plural and are always followed by a plural verb. Words like news, physics, arts, economics, aeronautics, measles, pumps, rickets, etc. are singular and are followed by singular verbs. Okay? Check, if you read all these things, you can able to solve it properly. Tick the right answer. Now you just have to tick the right one. Where to use many and where to use much. I already told you children, if you remember, that many we are taking for the things which we can count. Much we are taking for the things which we cannot count. In the same way, a little we are taking for the things which we cannot count. A few we are taking for the things which we can count. Okay, so the first one, how dash students are there in the class? So can we count students? Yes. So how many students are there in the class? How dash work have you done today? Can you count the work? No. So how much? She gave me dash old coins from her collection. Can we count old coins? Yes. So a few. Can I ask you dash questions? So can I ask you a few questions? Because whoever will be asking questions, it will be countable. I need dash rest. Can you count rest? No. So I need a little rest. So till 5, I have done for you. Rest 5, you have to do by yourself. Before doing it, kindly read, did you know? The words many, a few, some, a, an are used with countable nouns. The words a little, some, much, etc. are used with uncountable nouns. A little, a few means some. Little few means hardly anyone. Okay? Now, nouns, gender. So, types of gender nouns. How many types of gender nouns are there? Masculine gender, feminine gender, common gender, and neuter gender. How many are there? 4 types of gender nouns are there. They are masculine gender, feminine, common, and neuter. First of all, we'll see for masculine and feminine. Kinds of gender. In English language, genders are of 4 kinds. First, masculine gender. A noun which denotes a male person or an animal is known as masculine gender. Example, boy, brother, father, husband, uncle, wizard, king, son, etc. All this comes under your masculine gender. Feminine gender, a noun which denotes a female person or an animal is known as feminine gender. Example, girl, sister, mother, wife, aunt, witch, queen, daughter, etc. Understood masculine gender and feminine gender? Masculine means related to the male category. It can be a person or an animal. In the same way, feminine gender related to the female category. It can be a person or an animal. Examples I have already read for you. Okay, so a noun that refers to a male is said to be of the masculine gender, and a noun that refers to a female is said to be of the feminine gender. Next, common gender. Common, no man and no women and all those, common. Common gender refers to member of species that can be male or female. common gender refers to member of species that can be male or female. These can be either male or female. Like teacher, teacher can be a male also, teacher can be a female. Child, child can be a boy, child can be a girl. Worker, worker can be lady or gentleman. Friends, friends can be a boy, friend can be girl. Cousin, boy or girl. Neighbors, boy or girl, etc. So, common gender means all these are the examples of common gender in which it doesn't refer specially that they are male or female, but in general they comes under the common gender. A noun that can be used to refer to both male and female is said to be of the common gender. Understood? Last one, neuter gender. On neuter gender, maleness and femaleness doesn't apply. Okay, for neuter gender, maleness or femaleness doesn't apply. These are neither male nor female, like book, table, pen, gold, school and rock. These are usually non-living things. Now understand, what are neuter gender? Neuter gender are a noun that refers to things without life. They are the non-living things like pen, pencil, chair, table, all these comes under your neuter gender. They are not male, not either female. Understood everyone? Now see, it's given over here. A noun that refers to a male is said to be of the masculine gender. A noun that refers to a female is said to be of the feminine gender. A noun that can be used to refer to both male and female is said to be of the common gender. A noun that refers to things without life is said to be the neuter gender. That's what we have studied now. Write the other gender of these nouns. Now you have to tell me the other gender of these nouns. Fiance, fiancé. Bride, groom. Wizard, witch. Priest, priests. Author, authoress. Master, mistress. So this six I told you. The rest you people have to do by yourselves. Like Duke, Ram. Duke will be Drake. Ram, sheep. Landlord, landlady. Peacock, peahen. In the same way, the rest you people have to do by yourself. If you won't be able to do, you can ask me through WhatsApp. Either, otherwise you can get the notes also. Okay. Next, nouns possessive forms. What is noun possessive form? Possessive nouns are those nouns that shows possessions. This I am teaching you from class 6 if you people remember. Remember the Jim and Della chapter which we have learnt? What was the possession of Jim and what was the possession of Della? Della's beautiful hair was her possession, is it? And Jim's gold watch was his possession, isn't it? So possession means any article in which you are having your ownership. Like for example, now you people are not present in front of me, otherwise I would have showed you. Like I am holding a mobile phone in my hand, and if I gave this mobile phone to the person who is sitting in front of me, to any one of you, so whether this mobile phone belongs to that person, whether that person's possession will be this mobile phone of mine? No. Why? Because this phone is mine. It is my possession. I just gave to that front person for use. So it will not become his possession. It will be mine always. Okay. So the things in which you are the owner, in which you are having the ownership, that comes under your possessive nouns. Certain rules are also given. Let me read for you. Possessive nouns are those nouns that show possession. Possessive nouns are used to show ownership. Rule 1. In singular nouns, person, place, thing or idea, we add apostrophe and s after the noun. So whenever we people are showing that it is singular noun, place, person, thing, at that time what we have to do? We have to just put apostrophe S after the noun. Like for example, Ron's car is in the garage. So here Ron's, many Ron's are not there, only one person Ron is there. But because it is possessive noun, we have to write on R-O-N apostrophe S, Ron's. Second, in singular nouns ending with S, we add an apostrophe and S to the noun. Tom's notebook is lying on the table. Here also Tom's apostrophe S, John's apostrophe S. In singular nouns ending with S, followed by a word starting with S, we just add an apostrophe to the noun. This is to avoid a hissing sound. Like Tejas, school. So Tejas S, it is ending with S, school S, it is starting with S. That's why we have put up the apostrophe after the S. Is it? After S we have put up apostrophe. But here you see, before S we have put up the apostrophe. See these examples. Before S, and this one after S. Just to avoid that hissing sound. Understood? Next, in plural nouns ending with S, we add apostrophe after S. That is, students' report cards are ready. Students' apostrophe. Because it is a plural noun and it comes under your possessive noun. Girls, it also will be a plural one. Girls' dance classes have been postponed. In irregular plural nouns, men, children, we add apostrophe and S to show possessions. Children's apostrophe. Children, see, children is already, children means it is plural. But we put apostrophe S just for showing the irregular plural noun. Peoples. People already means plural, but we have put up apostrophe S to show that it is irregular plural noun. So this is the rules. Okay. Now I'll read the book work for you. We add an apostrophe and an S to a noun to show ownership of a relationship. We use S after singular nouns or names. For plural nouns that end in S, we just add an apostrophe after the S. Some examples, two examples are given to you. Rest you have to do by yourself. Add the possessive apostrophe wherever necessary. The owner, the car. So, the owner of the car. The mother, Gita. So, Gita's mother. Singular, apostrophe will come first. The top, the page. The top of the page. Here it's not necessary. The name, this street. This street's name, streets. Before S, we have to put apostrophe. Streets. Okay, singular. The toys, the children. So, toys also plural, children also plural. So, how we have to use over here? The children's toy. Children will be apostrophe S, and after that you will put over there apostrophe. Just now I told you irregular plural noun. So this children is irregular plural noun. So what will come over here before? Apostrophe will come after putting S. In the same way, rest you have to do by yourselves. If you won't be able to do, you can ask me. And if you want, you can ask me this picture of the possessive nouns so that it will be easy for you to see from here and to read the rules and can solve. Okay. The last one is read the following passage and answer the questions that follow. So this will be your homework, as you people have to read this unseen passage and then you have to solve the questions given at the bottom. Okay? See children, this paragraph writing was left out. It is from the previous chapter which we have learned from articles. From that side it was left out. So this paragraph writing, you have just received a gift from your aunt who lives in the US. Describe it to your friend and tell her how you feel. So that you have to write over here. Okay? This is from the articles chapter. Okay? This you have to solve. But one more paragraph writing is there. It is in your page number 32. And that paragraph writing is from noun chapter. You don't have to do that.
पैराग्राफ राइटिंग. पेज नंबर 32, वन पैराग्राफ राइटिंग इज देयर फ्रॉम द नाउन चैप्टर. यू डोंट हैव टू डू दैट पैराग्राफ राइटिंग. ओके, I hope you all understood the grammatical portion, the nouns. If you have any doubt, you can ask me through WhatsApp. And related to answers, you will get through the broadcast. From there, you can check your answers whether they are right or wrong. The next topic will start in the next class. Thank you, dear children.